Hello students and welcome to this video of mobile and wireless communication. In this video we are going to study the UMTS standards. I am Mrs. Pawar. These are the course outcomes. And these are the unit outcomes of fourth unit. Let's see the history of mobile communication. In first generation, it was analog communication and analog cellular. The most prominent system was Advanced Mobile Phone System AMPS, Nordic Mobile Telephone NMT, and Total Access Communication System TACS. In second generation, multiple and digital systems came, which included Global System for Mobile Communication, that is GSM, Digital AMPS, DAMPS, Personal Communication Services, PCS, and Japanese Standard Personal Digital Communication, PDC. Then in third generation, it extended the services provided by current second generation systems to offer high data rate services, such as multimedia telephone, video conference, video games, and provided universal coverage and enabled terminals to be able to move seamlessly between all networks in anywhere of the world. So what is UMTS? UMTS means Universal Mobile Telecommunication Systems, and it was the most important IMT 2000 proposal. Apan magcha video madhe IMT 2000 baghitlelo hota. It was International Mobile Telecommunication Standard, and it came around 2000 year. So it had many proposals. One of them, or most important proposal under IMT 2000, was UMTS. UMTS is Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. So it is a 3G GSM successor standard. 3G is a next standard. 3G GSM cha purcha UMTS hai. It is being developed by 3GPP, a joint venture of several SDOs, ETSI Europe, ARIB, TTC Japan, ANSI T1 USA, TTA South Korea, and CWTS China. So all these are developing the UMTS standard. Incorporates enhanced GSM phase 2 plus CNs with GPRS and CAMEL. In UMTS, a new radio access network, UMTS Terrestrial Radio Access Network, its acronym is UTRAN, is introduced. UMTS मध्ये हे एक नवीन type of network introduce केला गेला. Its name is UTRAN, Universal, or UMTS Terrestrial Radio Access Network, which will support PS data and CS data. Handover between UMTS and GSM is supported, and handover between UMTS and other 3G systems will be supported to achieve true worldwide access. So this UMTS can hand over from UMTS to GSM and also from UMTS to other 3G systems. Using this UMTS, worldwide access can be achieved. UMTS is a complete system architecture, as in GSM, emphasis on standardized interfaces, mix and match equipment from various vendors, simple evolution from GPRS allows one to reuse or upgrade some of the GPRS backhaul equipment, backward compatible handsets and signaling to support inter-mode and inter-system handoffs. Inter-mode means TDD to FDD, time division to frequency division, and FDD to again time division. इंटर सिस्टम UMTS टू GSM और UMTS टू GPRS. UMTS सपोर्ट्स अ वैरायटी ऑफ यूजर डेटा रेट्स एंड बोथ पैकेट एंड सर्किट स्विच सर्विसेस. सिस्टम कंपोज्ड ऑफ थ्री मेन सब सिस्टम्स. सो UMTS हैज़ अ कंप्लीट आर्किटेक्चर. इट वॉज सिमिलर टू GSM. जसं GSM मध्ये फुल आर्किटेक्चर आपण स्टडी केलं, स्टँडर्डायझेशन इंटरफेसेस होते. सिमिलरली UMTS इज हॅविंग अ कंप्लीट सिस्टम आर्किटेक्चर. So this is the architecture of UMTS system. As you can see here, there are different interfaces. UE manje user equipment that interfaces with the user. Then UTRAN, that is UMTS Terrestrial Radio Access Network, handles all radio related functionality, and WCDMA is radio interface standard here. So in UMTS, the standard radio interface standard is WCDMA, wideband code division multiple access. Then CN, core network, is responsible for transport functions such as switching and routing calls and data and tracking users. So mainly there are four type of interfaces: UE, user equipment interface, UTRAN, and standard is WCDMA, then core network and external networks. So let's see all of them one by one. UE, user interface, has mobile equipment, ME. It is the single or multimode terminal used for radio communication. USIM, that is UMTS subscriber identity module, is a smart card that holds the subscriber identity, subscribe services and authentication and encryption keys. जसं आपलं सिम असतं फोनमधलं, इट इज सिमिलर USIM असं त्याचं आपण nomenclature दिलेलं आहे. देन वॉट इज UTRAN? इन अंडर UTRAN, इट इज UMTS नेटवर्क, करेक्ट. Then it has node B equivalent to BTS in GSM or GPRS. So GSM मध्ये BTS होतं, करेक्ट, बेस ट्रान्सव्हर स्टेशन. हियर वी हॅव नोड बी सिमिलर टू इट. इट परफॉर्म्स द एअर इंटरफेस प्रोसेसिंग, दॅट इज चॅनल कोडिंग, रेट अडॅप्टेशन, स्प्रेडिंग, सिंक्रोनायझेशन अँड पॉवर कंट्रोल. अँड इट कॅन ऑपरेट अ ग्रुप ऑफ अँटेनास अँड रेडिओज. RNC, दॅट इज रेडिओ नेटवर्क कंट्रोलर, इट इज इक्विवॅलंट टू GSM BSC, बेस स्विचिंग सेंटरशी सिमिलर इथे RNC असतो. इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर रेडिओ रिसोर्स मॅनेजमेंट अँड कंट्रोल ऑफ द नोड BS. देन हँड ऑफ डिसिजन्स, कंजेशन कंट्रोल, पॉवर कंट्रोल, एनक्रिप्शन, ॲडमिशन कंट्रोल, प्रोटोकॉल कन्वर्जन एक्सेट्रा विल बी हँडल्ड बाय दिस RNC. Now we have seen the UMTS architecture. In that diagram we had seen this block also, UTRAN. Now this is the architecture of that UTRAN. Okay. Now here we have RNS and RNC. Also we have node B. RNC is radio network controller and RNS is radio network subsystem. So here you can see all the UEs are connected to node B. Okay, this node B supports FDD or TDD or both, and then it is interfaced with RNC. RNC is connected to CN, core network. So UTRAN contains several RNSs. Node B can support FDD or TDD. RNC is responsible for handover decisions requiring signaling to the UE, user interface, and cell offers FDD or TDD. Now we will see the description of this diagram. CN is core network and it has HLR, home location register. database located in the user's home system that stores the master copy of the user's service profile. The HLR also stores the UE location on the level of MSC and SGSN. Then 3G MSC or VLR, visitor location register. Switch and database that services the UE in its current location for current switched services. The MSC function is used to switch the CS transactions, and VLR function holds a copy of visiting user service profile as well as more precise information on the UE's location within the serving system. So the visitor location register will store the information of visiting users, and HLR means home location register will store the master copy of user service profile. Then we have 3G GMSC, Gateway MSC, Mobile Switching Center. Switch at the point where UMTS is connected to the external CS networks. All incoming and outgoing CS connections go through GMSC. 3G SGSN, that is serving GPRS support node, is similar to MSC or VRL, but is used for packet switch services. The part of the network that is accessed via SGSN is often referred to as the PS domain. Upgrade version of serving GPRS support node. And next is 3G GGSN, Gateway GPRS support node. Functionality is close to that of GMSC, but is in relation to PS services. Upgraded version of Gateway GPRS support node. Now, this core network and interface U are separated into two logical domains: circuit switch domain CSD and packet switch domain PSD. The circuit switch, including signaling, resource reservation at connection setup, and 3G versions of GSM components, MSC, GMSC, VLR, and HLR, and IUCS, that is interface units. Then the packet switch domain handles all packet data services, 3G versions of GPRS components, IUPS, and general approach of building on GSM GPRS infrastructure helps to save and faster deployment. This is the architecture of core network. We have BSS, in which BTS and BSC are there. Then we have ABIS interface, then interface unit. Then we have PSTN, inside that VLR, MSC, GMSC, EIR, home location register, HLR. Then we have RNS, in which node B and RNC is there. So here you can see all of them are interfacing with each other, all of them are communicating with each other in this UMTS, in the core network architecture. This is the evolution from GSM to GPRS. You can see in the diagram, base station controller is connected to mobile switching center, VLR, Gateway MSC, and HLR, home location register. And voice and data are transmitted simultaneously. In this diagram, the evolution from GSM to GPRS to UMTS evolution is shown. Now, all the mobile stations are connected to the radio network controller, and it is in turn connected to core network of UMTS, in which voice and data is transmitted. Now we will see the WCDMA, wideband code division multiple access. It is the radio air interface standard for UMTS. Then wideband direct sequence of spread spectrum, then variable orthogonal spreading for multiple access is there. Three types of interfaces are there: FDD, separate uplink or downlink frequency bands with constant frequency offset between them, TDD, uplink and downlink in same band but time shares transmissions in each direction, dual mode, it supports FDD also and TDD also. Then wide range of data rates due to CDMA with variable spreading, coding and modes, varying user bit rate is mapped to variable power and spreading. Different services can be mixed on a single carrier for a user. And there are 5 MHz channel of 25 GSM channels. And each service provider can deploy multiple 5 MHz carriers at same cell set. Each 5 MHz shared by multiple subscribers using CDMA. And maximum chip rate is 3.84 M chips per second. Standard advantages of CDMA is soft handoff, frequency reuse, cluster size of 1, better quality in multipath environment, rake receivers and QPSK modulation. So here we have finished the UMTS standards, and in next lecture we will see the CDMA 2000 standards. Thank you for watching.